Vice Chancellor, fellow graduates, it's a bit awesome to be in front of so many handsome and beautiful people with a life yet to make when you are slowly declining to the end of yours. I wondered what I should say because the letter that was sent to me inviting me to this very prestigious position said, would you perhaps say a few words that are uplifting to let people go off into the afternoon with some nice thoughts? And I thought, no. When you get to be 61 years old, which is what I am, and you look back on a life, there are a number of things you've learnt that you'd like to pass on to people that aren't that polite. The first thing I would tell you all in this room is don't waste a single second of your life trying to be the person your parents want you to be. Because by the time you're their age, you'll discover they didn't have a clue. I speak as a parent. The other thing I would say is to trust your instincts. By golly, trust your instincts, because the people you have to defend yourself against are the people I like to hurt. You know what they're called? They're called negative people. When you see one, kill them immediately because they are alien spawn. What you need to go away from here believing, I have discovered already to be true. At most of your ages now, you probably believe that there's a phrase which is your olders and betters. Forget this, there are just olders. There are no ceilings. When you get to be 61 years old, you find the tremendous disappointment that those that you thought were most suited to govern you and to lead you in all respects are usually imposters. There is nothing in your way to having the life you want to have. The other thing is the tremendous terror when you leave here. I don't know yet what I want to do, so I'm going to grab that. I bet you most of you feel that. You know, I only discovered what I wanted to do when I was 37 years old. It's amazing. Everything else that happened was an accident. I just grabbed accident after accident after accident. You know what? Marvelous things do not happen by meeting the people you need to meet. Marvelous things happen by meeting the people you didn't know you needed to meet. People in high places are not the people you need to know. They are the right people in low places you need to know. Okay. As I bid farewell to you, I would love you, I can't, I have no right, but I would beg you all, any of you under the age of 150, to forswear ever reading the Daily Mail again. And I say this because we are amongst scientists, and did you realize that almost every major media organization in the world is owned by an arts graduate? That's why you have science correspondents, those people in the corner that say a few interesting things about getting fat. Yeah? Now, we are living at a time that is absolutely sensational. 150 years from now, people will discuss this period in our history as being bigger than the Renaissance. The amount of scientific discovery and advances made over the last 15 years exceed all scientific advances made in the history of humankind before that. But if you read the Daily Mail, you would not know that. No, if you read the Daily Mail, you would believe at the end of every road there's a crack dealer, that every person you meet is going to kill you, that actually every man is a paedophile, every woman is a shoplifter. It is not true. We live in miraculous times. It is better to be alive today than at any time ever, ever, ever. Remember that as you leave this place. You are living in a blessed time where there are no ceilings on what you can be, and all you need to have to clothe you is kindness and trust. Those are the virtues. When you go to conferences with a load of tossers telling you about innovation and the way to be entrepreneurial and the way to do this and the way to do that, the first rule of a happy life and a successful life is to dare to trust. Even when you face disappointment, learn to trust again. Then you will be happy. If that is all you remember, and not to read the Daily Mail, I'll be very pleased to have been here. Thank you so much.